Hello everyone. Let's start today's class. In yesterday's class, we have learned cells connected in series. Now in today's class, we are going to learn cells in parallel. What is the topic? Here, electric cells in parallel. So if you have seen, generally we won't connect cells in parallel. Why? Because even though we have connected cells in parallel, it is of no use, because EMF you will get the one who is having maximum. Yes, that is what EMF of one cell we can say. Let's see how it is. So see here. Pen N identical shell. N identical cells connected in parallel with external resistance capital R. Let's draw one small diagram for this. You can see here all cells we have connected in parallel. So therefore the diagram will be something like this. I am keeping here dot 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 dot, means so many like this branches we have connected. This is first cell, its internal resistance is R. This is second cell, its internal resistance is R. This is third, its internal resistance is R. And like that, how many cells we have? So many cells we are having, that is N cells we are having. So see here, when we are having N cells, what will be the net EMF? What will be the net EMF? Let's see. So as you are having N cells, but then also you are getting the EMF of one cell only. So what is that? See here. total EMF will be equal to only E, not N times E, because these are the parallel combinations. All cells we have created in parallel combination. Next one, total internal resistance, we can say, or effective also you can write, effective internal resistance. Is equal to R by N. Why R by N? In parallel combination, we have learned if same resistance connected in parallel N times, its resistance is what? R by N. For example, if suppose 4 ohm resistance you have connected 2 times, what is net resistance? 4 by 2, that is 2 ohm. Similarly, here also this R, how many times we have connected? N times we have connected. Therefore, effective internal resistance is what here? R by N. Next one, total resistance I am saying here. Total resistance in the circuit will be equal to R by N plus R. Yes or not? And next one, as usual, we are learning what the total current in the circuit. So how much it will be? Total current is equal to this total EMF E divided by R by N plus R. If we will solve this, R plus N R by N, and this N, if it will go up, then it is becoming like this, N E by N into capital R plus small r. Yes or not? Check it. Take LCM. Its denominator is 1. So 1 into R. R plus N into R, NR divided by N into 1 is N, and this is going up here. Understanding? That's what it is, NE by NR plus R. So note down this. Okay, next. Now, if number one note point here, condition number one, if external resistance is very, very greater than R by N. Okay, this external resistance is very, very greater than this total internal resistance, we can see. Same like how we have learned in cells in a series concept, same conditions we are having. So if like this is there, then how much you will get current? I is equal to E by R. What we are getting? E by R. That is what we can say. Current from one cell only. Yes. Next point, if we are taking reverse case means what here? Now, if this R is very, 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 very less than this R by N, then the current through the circuit will become what? Ne divided by small r. You can see from backside formula, here only it is. If this r we have neglected, then this Nn will get cancelled, E by R. If suppose this we have neglected, then this is what? the current is. You can see clearly from the formula. You are getting same thing. Okay. So next one, see here. For two cells, see here, I am drawing diagram also. For two cells, or just to write for two different cells connected in parallel. What I am writing? Two different cells connected in parallel. Okay. So heading will be like this. Two different cells connected in parallel. Shall we draw the diagram? Okay, so let's see how it will be. Like these two cells we are going to connect across a internal resistance. Yes. So two different cells we are having. So I am taking this cell as a E1 and its internal resistance is R1. This is cell number 2, E2, and its internal resistance is R2 and external resistance is R. Now see here, current flowing through this is, let us suppose I1. Current flowing through this is I2. And this current is what? Complete current I, which is flowing through this. Yes or not? Clear? Then if such type of thing is there, then what is the case? Let's see. Point number one. See here. Effective EMF, we can say. Effective EMF for this case is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, this is what your effective EMF is. Next point you see, effective EMF we have learned. Effective internal resistance. So direct I am writing R effective, that is internal resistance, small r, you know, small r. R effective is equal to what? As these two resistances are in parallel. So you know parallel formula, R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Next case, if I want the current through the circuit, you know, next point, if suppose I want current, that is I, okay, not I1 and not I2, this is I. So this I is equal to total EMF divided by R effective plus this capital R, right? Total EMF and this R effective. R effective is obviously this, whatever the value are getting substitute here and just add to the internal external resistance, you will get the current. Next one. Now we know the total current I1 plus I2. I is equal to I1 plus I2. So what is the I1 value and what is the I2 value? So here you are getting I1 is equal to E1 minus IR divided by internal resistance, and I2 is equal to what you will get, E2 minus IR divided by this R2. And one more, that is terminal potential of the cell, we can say. One more formula, that is if I want terminal potential of cell, this is equal to capital E, okay? E effective means this E. So that you can substitute this E only. Understand? Because this potential is common for all, including these two cells. That's why this effective EMF we should take here. So VT is equal to E into capital R divided by R plus R effective. This is what terminal potential across the cell in this case. Okay. What is this? Terminal potential across the cells, including two, means here you want, you can say here at this point, or you can take here also, here, this red spots you can see, no, here. So this is terminal potential including these two cells, not for one cell, understand? Okay, so note down this. Okay, so let's go ahead. Now we will see the mixed grouping. Okay. What is this mixed grouping? Let's see. Next concept, that is mixed grouping. Mixed grouping means what? Sometimes some cells we can say we are connecting in parallel, some cells we are connecting in series. And then what are the changes and what is the conditions we are going to use? When is the maximum current? Let's see. First, keep the heading. So let's draw the diagram for this case first. See here, if n identical cells are connected in a row and such a m rows are connected in parallel, as shown. So what is this mixed grouping? One more time, see, according to the statement, you are having n identical cells, means how many cells we are having? N number of cells are there. These cells are in one row. In one row, how many cells are there? N. And like that, one below another, like that, complete, what you can say, series of cell is connected in parallel. So let's see the diagram. I am drawing diagram, then you will understand what actually the meaning of this sentence. So see, this is a first row. Okay. Like this. Okay, so on till we can say EN. Is that clear? So this is first cell, this is second cell, this is third cell, this is fourth cell, and so on. This is nth cell. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is nth cell. Each cell is identical. Every cell has EMF E and internal resistance R only. Is that clear? Now, like this, how many rows we have connected in parallel? See, now this is another row, we can say. Is another row. And in this row also you are having like these cells only. Can you see? And then like this till end. Okay, similarly third one. Like this only. Same number of cells we have connected in parallel. And then like this. Okay, understanding. So can you see? Like this, and same like this. So like this, how many rows we are having, you know? Like this, m rows we are having. Okay, and this side, you see, this one. How many cells? N cells in a one row. N cells in a one row, and how many rows like that? M number of rows. And this is what your current flow. We can say this is I through this circuit. If like this mixed grouping is there, then equivalent EMF will be what? So equivalent EMF. Who will tell me? Obviously, equivalent EMF will be what? The EMF produced by one, what we can say, one, what is this? One branch, we can say. So how many cells we are having? N cells. So each cell is having EMF E. Therefore, total EMF is N E, because all are in parallel only. Assume karo ki there is only E in parallel, then you are getting effective how much EMF? E only. So here for one branch, how many cells we are having? N number of cells. Therefore, effective EMF is what? N into E. Next point. This finished about effective EMF. Next, internal resistance R equivalent is equal to, for this first branch, how many or how much is the resistance? See, for one cell you are having R plus R till N. So therefore, this is what? N into R. Now like this, this is one branch, it is having NR resistance. NR. How many times? M times. Therefore, can I write like this? NR by M. Because this is like NR is an identical resistance and we have connected in parallel M times. Therefore, NR by M. And hence, you are getting internal resistance is how much? NR by M. So, main current through the load, that is what I have denoted in the diagram. What you are getting here, NE is the total EMF, and this is NR by M plus R, we can say. If we will solve this, what we are getting? NM into E divided by MR plus NR. This is what your current is in this case. Next point, if you want the maximum power, that is condition for maximum power in this case. Condition for maximum power. Already we have learned this in maximum power transfer theorem. Condition for maximum power, that is if R is equal to NR by M. R is equal to NR by M, yes or not? When this is what? Internal resistance, this is what? External resistance. So already we know when internal resistance is equal to external resistance, then only power will be maximum. That's why R is equal to NR by M, then only condition for maximum power is proved. And here if like this thing is there, that is R is equal to NR by M, then P max is equal to, you are getting M into N into E square by 4R. Understand? This is what? Maximum power. One more time, try to understand. Equivalent EMF is NE, which is of one branch, because in parallel, how many cells we have connected in parallel? No matter. The one cell EMF only you will get. Here, one branch EMF you are getting. That's why NE. R equivalent, NR for one branch, like that M branches we have connected, therefore NR by M, and current already you know, and this maximum power is what condition? Internal resistance is equal to external resistance, and then the P max value you are getting as MN into E square by 4R, right? M into N into E square by 4R. So note down this. Okay, let's move ahead now. Next point, condition for maximum current in this case. So see here, in this mixed grouping, condition for maximum current. Condition for maximum current. What are the conditions? So for that, I want to give you, or I want to show you this formula. See here. Can you see this? This one. See here, this formula you see, or you see this formula, current formula, I is equal to NE by NR by M plus R. This formula you see, and then you will get to know the maximum current conditions. This formula you keep it in mind. So let's move ahead. So see here, what are the conditions? R by N plus small r by m is equal to minimum. Then d dm of m r by capital N plus r by m is equal to zero. Or not. So if we will take this derivative, what we are getting? This R by N minus R by M square is equal to zero. That is, R by N should be equal to R by M. Right? And what is this capital N here? This capital N is equal to N or M into N. Keep it in mind. This capital N is equal to what? M into N. So therefore, what is this capital N? This capital N is nothing but number of cells, nothing else. Why? Because you will understand. Number of cells, why I am saying? Because in one row, or we can say one branch, you are having N cells. Like that, how many branches? M. So M into N, you will get number of cells. That's why this capital N is there. Understand? And what is the small N? Small N is number of cells in one branch, and capital N is total number of cells. Complete circuit. Got it? So what we got? R by N is equal to small r by m, then you will get the maximum current. This is what the condition is for maximum current. Therefore, can I write like this? So, in case of mixed grouping of cells, in case of mixed grouping of cells, current in the circuit, current in the circuit will be maximum when R by N is equal to small r by M. Then what is the maximum value, sir? See here. I max is equal to NE by 2R. NE by 2R. N into capital E divided by 2R, that is also equal to m into e divided by 2 into small r. How you got this? By putting this value only. Where there is r by n, you substitute this r by m, or even at the place of r by m, you substitute r by n, you will get the same thing. Okay? Right? Understand? You can keep this into the box, this condition and this maximum current. Got it? Note down. Today also I am sending you problems. Two problems I am sending on this model. Don't forget to do. So many are neglecting. Please don't neglect the problems. Try to solve it. And those who are getting the answer, send it on group after checking. Once you have checked, first send me, check your answers, and then send it on groups. Okay? Don't neglect. Right? Please solve the problems. Note down this. Today also I am sending you only two problems, not more also. Just two problems you solve. Right? Okay. Then let's stop here for today. Tomorrow we'll start very important topic, that is Kirchhoff's laws. And in IPE you are getting 8 marks question on it. So don't miss tomorrow's class. Okay? And solve problems whatever I'm sending. Okay. Bye for today.